We just saw a really serious risk in Drupal 7, and it had a published CVE and an entry in the exploit database that explains exactly how to exploit that system. Now, in your ethical hacking, you'll probably be coming from the perspective of testing an existing system, a known system, and looking to see if it's properly secured against risks. But just for context, there are those who deliberately seek out other systems that may be at risk, not necessarily the ones that they're responsible for. And once they understand that a risk like SQL injection exists in a framework like Drupal, it's very easy to use a tool like Shodan to then go and find at-risk systems. So let's try this. I'm just going to search for Drupal 7. Now, what Shodan has done is it's gone away and looked for sites that are returning the Drupal 7 banner. So we looked at banner grabbing a little bit earlier on with wget. And what we're seeing here is exactly what you'd get in a banner grabbing exercise. So these are the response headers that the servers are sending. And we've found a huge number of results for Drupal 7. Now, it doesn't necessarily tell us whether they're patched or not. But had you done this in the very early hours after that vulnerability was disclosed, you'd experience a very high hit rate of finding servers that weren't protected. So whilst this may not be the normal approach you'd take in ethical hacking, I did want to point this out just to make it clear how easy it can be to discover at-risk systems using free, publicly available tools.